everybody. Thanks for taking the time to watch the video of my 16 millimeter projector here made by Kodak. And actually this is what they call a 250S. 250S is in Sam. That's the model of this projector. And this thing has been sitting on the shelf for a long time. And I got it out here, and I have to familiarize myself with it because it's been a long time. So for now, I can mention to you that it's in really good shape, and inside and out looks good. And it has kind of interesting. Maybe all of them are that way. This is a sound projector. And so we have a speaker here that's an external speaker that you can use or you don't have to use. And it has a jack. Oh, I think they call that an RCA jack. And it plugs in to the front right here. So if you plug it in, you can use this speaker. You see the grill right here and you can see the speaker, I hope. And then if you don't plug it in, the projector has its own internal speaker right here. You can see the grill. So what I'm going to do is bring the camera up closer so we can just kind of look at everything. And it's been a while, so I really do need to get familiar with it again. So again, thank you so much for taking the time to watch the video and put up with me while I'm showing you this. On the front of the camera, I might as well show you this first. There's a knob. Hopefully you can see this black knob. And when you turn it, you can tilt the camera. It's got a leg that comes out, padded leg. You see it right here. It's padded here and padded here. So anyway, that way you can line it up with the screen or whatever the background is that you're going to show the movie. This is a closer view and a better view of the speaker. You can see it in here nestled in the cabinet. And then the speaker wire that you can unwind and set this quite a ways away in the room that you're going to be watching pictures if you want. This appears to be an RCA, I think that's what you call it, jack. And then over here on the projector is the other part of the jack where you plug it in to operate this. On the front side of this, you see a little dimple right here. Somebody at one time or another pushed something up next to it, and I don't know how to get that out, but it makes no difference whatsoever on the quality of the machine. The other thing you might want to take note to is on either side you see these clips, and you also see at the very bottom two little brackets. These two brackets fit in to the projector right here and right here. You can see that here and there. And then when you close the lid, when you rotate it, you just snap these against the lock right here, one on each side. So the two arms that you can't see very well is this one I'm moving and this one right here. And each one of them has its own little belt or drive. So this belt right here will go, this belt right here will go to this bottom one when I lift it up, and I'll show you in a better view. And then this one, when I lift it up, it's already got this drive right already on it, so you don't have to mess with it. So this arm, I'm just going to lift up, pretty easy, you don't have to mess with it. And there it is. The bottom arm, or the other arm, excuse me, you lift it up, and it's spring-loaded. So when you take this belt, I'm trying to do this so I don't have my hands in the way and you can see what I'm doing. And there's a little pulley right here. And you just take and go over the shaft part around the pulley. So this right here is the power cord that's tucked inside of here for convenience. This is the on-off button. This is the actual jack, which I think is RCA for the speaker that we were looking at. Here's the volume control knob for the volume, and the tone for the volume, tone knob. This is for a microphone, This is for auxiliary input of some sort. And then this switch right here is for in this position here, you're strictly listening to the film if you have sound film in here. And in this position, you can put an auxiliary mic in here, I believe, and you can narrate the film as well. But this button right here is in the off position, and this turns the motor on. Of course, you've got to turn the power on first. And then this turns the lamp on with the motor. Okay, so there's motor, there's off, and then here's motor, and here's lamp. So this is reverse on this side, and this is forward on this side. I'm trying to get my hands in there. So there's a switch right here, and it says sound on this side and silent movies on this side, but it will not, you cannot move this lever until you move the switch right here where you have the motor and then the lamp on the forward position. Whoops. Then you can move it. That's silent. Or, let's see, sound. That's sound. So you push it and it detents and sticks there. If I lift up on it, it comes back to the sound. If I have it in rewind, that's rewind position, you can't do anything with this lever. Whether it's motor, lamp, motor, doesn't make any difference. That's rewind position, and this won't move. So it does have to be, and even the off, it won't work. It has to be over here on sound movies, either motor or lamp. And then you can switch it. So, okay, that's off. Power off. Power on. Little red light comes on here. All right. Forward without the light. There's forward with the light. That's off. And then this is reverse. Motor only. Motor and lamp. Well, I was rummaging through all my stuff back there in my pack rat department, and I could not find the 16mm film that I wanted to put on here. I have it, but I couldn't access it. I did find a microphone, however, to something else that has that RCA jack on it. And I found out, because I was playing around with this thing, that on the side of the projector, and I was showing you this screen over here, this screen. That's a vent. There might be a motor or a fan inside there or something, but that's a vent. I thought that was a speaker, but it's not. So if you're using this for sound, that's the speaker that you really need to plug into it. Okay, so what I'm going to do is plug in the speaker into the speaker jack. Okay, there's into the speaker jack. And I'm going to plug the microphone into the microphone jack. And I'm going to turn on this white switch on the panel. And I don't want it to feed back, but I think you could hear the difference in my volume of speaking with the speaker over here. And if I turn off the speaker, well, better yet, I could just take the speaker away from my mouth and you can hear the difference. There's a couple other things on here that I want to show you, and I'll just put it on close up so you can see. There's a button, there's some kind of a knob right here, which evidently turns the mechanism one frame at a time to adjust the fine tuning. There's this thing here that pulls out and has something to do with rewinding. Pushes in, I don't know exactly what that is. And I haven't figured out what this thing is. Maybe it's some sort of fine tuning, this knob. And the lens itself will turn and it goes in and out for focusing. There's a little lever right here. It says sound focus. So I'm not sure what that means or what it does, but evidently it has something to do with synchronizing the sound to the picture. So this black knob, which at the moment I'm not sure what it does, right behind it there's a little thumb screw, chrome thumb screw, and I loosen it up and this comes off, and that is where the bulb goes, low, medium, high. I don't know what that does. So by turning this dial right here, right there, it actually changes, it makes something go up and down, which changes the way that the frame is seen on the screen. There's a squirrel cage fan in there, and that's what cools everything in the light. And so that grill on the side of the camera, what I thought was a speaker, isn't a speaker, it's an air intake so that that fan operates correctly. I'm going to turn the light off, and then maybe you can see that wheel for the frames as well. So I've got the cord wrapped up and I'm pushing it back in its cavity where it came from. I'm attempting to. Well, finally, I think I've pretty much come to the end of the presentation of this thing. And I know it's pretty amateurish, and I told you that it was going to be such, and you would be putting up with me here. So if you got to the end of this video, you definitely put up with me, and I thank you for that. So that's it, folks. Thanks again.